All right, so enabling auto updates for Chrome using Microsoft Intune. We're going to create a policy, but before we create a policy, we need to get the ADMX templates for Google Chrome. I just had a brain fart. Now, to do this, let's open up our favorite browser. It is up to you. I'm going to open up Chrome, right? Duh, Chrome. And we're going to go into the following URL. Now, once you're here, we're going to scroll down until you locate this and click on download ADMX templates. Click on that. You should get this. Great. Now, for the policy templates, we are going to accept and download. So click on that. And it's going to download the templates. All right, so we downloaded the first template. Great. Head back into that URL. Scroll down again. Locate this. Click on that. And it is time for us to download the update management templates. Now, by default, it is going to show you the ADM templates. We want the ADMX. So click on the dropdown and select ADMX. And click on accept and download. Bam. So you should have two zip folders. Open up the downloads folder or wherever you drop those zip files at. I dropped them into the downloads folder. And there we go. I'm going to select the Google Update ADMX zip file. I am going to right click on it. I am going to select bin zip and I am going to select extract files. Excellent. Click OK and we're done. We need to select the last zip. So select it, right click on it, go to 7-zip and then click on extract files and then click OK. There's a good chance that you don't have 7-zip. Don't worry about it. Windows operating system has its own built-in option to extract zip files. So just use that. Now, we're going to head over to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, which is right here. Great. On the left-hand side, let's click on Show All. We're going to locate and click on Microsoft Intune. On the left-hand side, let's click on Devices. Within the Devices overview, underneath Manage Devices, we are going to click on Configuration. So locate it and click on it. And right here, we have been doing a lot within the Policies tab. So let's head over to a new tab, which would be the Import ADMX. So click on that. Now, I already done this. I've done this on a last video. I don't know how long I pushed out that video, but I did this already. But I'm showing you guys how to do it in case you don't know how to do it, how to import those ADMX files. So we are going to click on import. And the first thing that we need to do is upload the ADMX file. So click on that little blue icon and locate your, you know, your zip files that you extracted. We're going to go into the policies template folder first. We're going to go into the Windows folder. And within here, let's go inside the ADMX folder. We're going to select Chrome and click on Open. Now, for me, I have a big red X. And the reason why, because it's already, you know, it already exists, right? But I'm showing you guys how to do it. We need to do the language. So click on the little blue icon and pick your language. I'm going to pick EN-US and then pick the Chrome. And then click on open. Once you're done, on the lower left-hand side, let's click on next. Nice little review, and then click on create. Now, I already did this. For me, it's going to fail because I already, you know, those templates already exist. Eventually, what's going to happen is as soon as you upload them into your tenant, underneath the status tab right here, right now, for me, it says available. But for you, when you're doing it the first time, it's going to say like uploading, uploading. It takes some time and eventually it's going to switch to green available, which is great. Now, let's head over into the policies tab. And within the policies tab, let's click on create. Let's click on new policy. You're going to get the side menu. Let's click on the drop down for platform. And we're going to pick Windows 10 and later. For the profile type, let's click on the dropdown and we are going to select templates and we're going to type in import. As soon as you type in import, we are going to locate and select imported administrative templates preview. So select that. On the lower left-hand side, let's click on create. Let's give our profile a name. I gave it the following. On the lower left-hand side, let's click on next. It is time for us to configure it. So this is going to tackle the computer section, not user section. So we're going to stay within the computer configuration section. So within here, we're going to double click on Google. We're going to double click on Google Update. We're going to double click on Applications. We're going to locate and double click on the folder called Google Chrome. And it is going to be the last option, Update Policy Override. So select that. It should give you a side menu. Perfect. It's not configured. We are going to enable it. The policy, by default, it is configured as the recommended option, always allow updates. Great. Click OK. On the lower left-hand side, let's click on Next. For tags, I typically don't do anything, so I leave it as the default. I'm going to click on Next here. For assignments, let's click on Add Groups and pick your group. This is going to be for computers, for devices, so make sure the security group that you have has computers. So I'm going to click on Select. On the lower left-hand side, we're going to click Next. On the lower left-hand side, let's click on Create. And on the upper right-hand side, it's going to say Profile Save, which is great. Give it some time, refresh the page. There goes our new policy. Now, the security group that I applied this policy to is this one. And this is a computer that I am going to head over and test, which is 5859. I have been using this for almost all of my videos with you guys. And when I check that computer and I go inside devices configuration, and within here, I locate that policy. Underneath the state column, it says seceded, which is great. It applied it, which is awesome. So let's head over to that machine, which is here. Let's open up Chrome. And to validate this, what you could do is go into Chrome policies. Go into this URL, hit enter, scroll all the way down until you see Google Update Policies. You should see something here. Update policy. The value is 1, source is platform, apply to the machine, level is mandatory, status is okay. Now, you're probably saying to yourself, yeah, that's for all the machines. Yeah, but for my regular machine that I'm actually, you know, using right now, my Chrome, the host machine, my Chrome, which is this right here, if I go into that same URL and I go into the Google Update Policies, I don't have anything there. That's empty. My host doesn't have that. You know, 5859 has it because I pushed out that Intune policy. That's the reason why it's there. It's working. Yes, awesome. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.